So, it's been an electric few weeks in the world of AI. We've been hearing a lot of groundbreaking news from several tech giants. Microsoft, for example, has hired two of Inflection AI's co-founders who will lead its newly established unit, Microsoft AI. And now, Amazon is investing billions of dollars in Anthropic AI, the company behind the powerful AI model Claude that just surpassed ChatGPT. And make no mistake about it, there's a clear connection here. Major tech players are in a high-stakes race toward a monumental breakthrough, artificial general intelligence, or AGI. The entire AI community is on the edge of their seats, eagerly awaiting the announcement that seems destined to arrive sooner rather than later. AGI is the holy grail of AI because it's not about teaching computers to excel at performing one specific task, like recognizing faces or playing chess, but about creating a machine that can learn, think, and solve problems across a wide range of functions, just like humans do. For years, AGI has been considered a far-fetched dream, but now we're witnessing unprecedented progress in AI systems, and as a result, leaders and visionaries in the AI community are publicly acknowledging the fact that AGI is no longer a dream, but is just around the corner. So, what do we really need to create machines that match and maybe surpass human intelligence? Do we currently possess the technological backbone necessary to bring AGI into existence? And perhaps more critically, are we, as a society, prepared for the implications of AGI's arrival? Well, people like Sam Altman believe that AGI could revolutionize many industries, ranging from healthcare to transportation, by automating tasks, improving efficiency, and making new material discoveries. Furthermore, we are living on a planet that is grappling with existential threats such as climate change, environmental pollution, global pandemics, and the pressing issue of resource depletion. By applying the advanced predictive capabilities of AGI, we can begin to address these issues more effectively. Plus, let's be honest with ourselves, who wouldn't like to have an AI assistant with superhuman capabilities? One that not only understands, but anticipates our needs and smoothly integrates solutions into our daily lives. Artificial general intelligence, or AGI, appears as a straightforward fix to a range of our complex challenges, but the creation of such advanced AI systems needs two crucial elements. First, it requires the creativity and analytical power of human intelligence. We need thinkers who can design systems that reflect and improve upon human cognitive processes. Secondly, the development of AGI demands significant computational resources. To bring AGI to life, we're not just talking about writing sophisticated code, we're also looking at the need for extensive computing power to support these intelligent systems in performing tasks that mimic human thought and behavior. OpenAI's research team stated that the computational power used to train AI systems has doubled roughly every 3.4 months since 2012. This surge in computational power, which is essential for training complex AI models like GPT-4, is an indicator that computing power is going to be the currency of the future. And in the AI world, it's GPUs and powerful AI chips that fuel the development of cutting-edge models and bring us closer to AGI. And now, Sam Altman and Microsoft are strategizing to navigate around NVIDIA's dominant position in the AI hardware market. The news came out that OpenAI and Microsoft are partnering together on an ambitious $100 billion project known as Project Stargate, aiming to establish a state-of-the-art AI data center. Set to launch in 2028, Stargate seeks to create a cutting-edge supercomputing infrastructure, positioning OpenAI for independence from external AI computing resource suppliers like NVIDIA. Stargate is expected to be a game-changer, potentially disrupting NVIDIA's market dominance and attracting businesses eager to develop sophisticated AI models. With Microsoft's financial support, possibly reaching over $115 billion, this project is a bold step towards self-reliance in AI data processing, and therefore gives a strategic advantage to OpenAI in the competitive field of AI. Altman and Microsoft are rolling this out in 5 planned phases, with the goal of launching a top-tier AI supercomputer by 2030. The current Phase 3 is the core of Project Stargate and focuses on custom AI chips tailored to boost the efficiency and speed of neural network computations, thereby facilitating faster and more efficient AI model training and inference processes. The meticulous design, fabrication, and integration of these chips underscore the technical prowess and innovative spirit driving the project. Beyond powerful AI chips and GPUs, Project Stargate aims to optimize these computing resources for scalability and redundancy, ensuring that the created supercomputer can handle a wide array of AI workloads with unparalleled efficiency and reliability. The next step, phase four, involves putting together a smaller supercomputer by 2026, setting the stage for the big finale, Stargate. The last step will use millions of AI chips to power the most advanced supercomputer ever built. Through Project Stargate, Microsoft and OpenAI are not only looking to build groundbreaking supercomputers, but also to address the critical need for advanced computational power, essential for pushing the boundaries of AI research and applications. But now, everyone is wondering, do we really need to spend $100 billion to build a supercomputer? In an interview with Lex Fridman, Sam Altman bluntly emphasized the urgent need for reactors and new energy methods to support the training of next generative AI models. He stressed that without them, we simply won't have the juice to power the plethora of supercomputers we're eager to deploy globally. And although they don't agree on most things yet, Elon Musk echoed this sentiment in a subsequent interview. So the reality here is that these data centers are power-hungry beasts, capable of single-handedly crippling a power grid. So Altman hinted that they may need to create several supercomputers and scatter them far and wide across the country, and maybe integrate some of them with nuclear power plants. This plan for OpenAI aims to establish a robust, secure, and distributed network with an enhanced resilience against cyber threats and sabotage. The rumors of Project Stargate sent shockwaves across the internet, revealing an ambitious step towards achieving artificial general intelligence, or AGI. Stargate's groundbreaking computing power, capable of handling complex algorithms and vast datasets, significantly surpassed current technology. This leap forward has sparked excitement and speculation about the future of AI, highlighting both the project's immense potential and the uncharted territories it aims to explore. But Sam Altman's ambitions stretch beyond Project Stargate, as he is trying to raise a staggering $7 trillion to build the hardware required for the next generative AI models. According to Altman, the chip shortage is only going to get worse and might result in slowing down AI developments. So his grand plan involves global fundraising efforts, including negotiations with international partners like the UAE government, to significantly ramp up chip production. This initiative is pivotal for ensuring OpenAI, among others, can scale without restraint. But why $7 trillion? That's more than three times the valuation of NVIDIA. Altman argues that this investment is necessary to secure a future where AI infrastructure, including semiconductor capacity, energy solutions, and data centers, is robust enough to support the relentless demand for AI advancements. Altman's proactive stance, rallying for this enormous investment, underscores a strategic push towards creating an unshakable foundation for artificial general intelligence. His endeavors suggest a larger blueprint for AGI's evolution, with Project Stargate's timeline intriguingly coinciding with projections for AGI's debut. Altman's comprehensive strategy points to a future where AGI thrives, supported by an advanced, resilient infrastructure. Now, at the beginning of this video, we posed a question whether as we as a society are ready for AGI. Well, this could be a long discussion on the impact of AGI, but during the development of AGI, these three main features should be accounted for: transparency, fairness, and safety. Transparency is the cornerstone of trust and comprehension in AGI systems. Imagine a financial AI advisor disclosing its decision-making rationale to investors, enabling them to grasp investment strategies, and instilling confidence in the AI's recommendations. This transparency ensures accountability and helps in identifying biases within the system. Fairness dictates that AGI systems operate without maintaining existing societal inequalities. For instance, in recruitment, an AI-powered hiring platform should ensure equitable opportunities regardless of race, gender, or socioeconomic status. Addressing biases in training data and implementing fair decision-making algorithms are pivotal to achieving this. Safety is paramount in AGI deployment to mitigate potential risks and hazards. For example, the emergence of AGI weaponry raises grave safety concerns. Picture autonomous AI weapons capable of identifying and engaging targets without human oversight. While hailed for their potential to enhance military precision and minimize civilian casualties, the risk of unintended consequences looms large. Malfunctions or misuse could result in catastrophic outcomes. For instance, a rogue AI drone might mistakenly target civilians or vital infrastructure, underscoring the imperative for strict regulations to mitigate potential harm and safeguard global security. So in conclusion, the race to AGI is on, and the successful implementation of Project Stargate could revolutionize AI research and redefine computational limits, pushing OpenAI and Microsoft to the forefront of this race. If you've made it this far, share your thoughts in the comments section below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe.